welcome.
Hi.
It's so good to see you
again. Good to see you, man.
I didn't realize until today your first television appearance was right here in 30 Rock.
That's true. In 1981, I did Tom Snyder Coast to Coast, Tomorrow Coast to Coast.
Yes.
In this very studio.
And here you are. Check it out. Very high production value.
I still have those pants.
You still have those pants.
I do.
That's great. Now, that is your drummer, but he does not have drums.
That was before we actually had a band together. That was John Bermuda Schwartz, and I met him on the Dr. Demento show, and basically I needed somebody to supply percussion for another one, Rides the Bus, and he said, I'm a drummer. I said, you can bang on my accordion case. So that was it.
That was all he did,
yeah.
So that was the percussion for another one, another one, Rides the Bus. Was that your first?
That was the first big single, yeah.
Okay, wow, that's amazing.
And after that, I thought, maybe we should put a band together. That might be more palatable for the public.
And I'm sorry, what was his name again?
John Bermuda Schwartz,
great. When you met somebody named John Bermuda Schwartz, you were like, probably said, you're going to get along great.
I think I gave him that name.
Okay, good. He's very lucky to have met you then.
Yes.
That began a recording contract. You had a record contract that lasted from then until now, right?
Well, that was before I had a record deal. I signed in 1982, and it was a 10-album deal at the time, which seemed crazy, but, you know, I was working in the mailroom, and I thought, well, sure, okay, I'll have 10 albums, why not?
Yeah.
And then the contract got renegotiated, and they tacked a few more albums onto it, and then it got renegotiated again, a few more albums. So it became a 14-album deal, which finally was fulfilled with mandatory funds. After 32 short years...
That's incredible. Yeah. So you had a 32-year
record
deal. That is
correct. It sounds like a joke when I say that, but that actually is true.
And this is the first... I mean, not only just your first number one album, it's the first comedy album to debut at number one on Billboard. Where were you when you found out? How did it make you feel?
Oh, gosh. I was backstage at Midnight, Chris Hardwick's
great show, yeah.
And I knew it was kind of battling it out for number one, and even that was... I couldn't wrap my head around that. But I was about to go on the air, and I get a message, oh, your manager wants to see you in the green room. And I thought, ooh, I wonder if this is it. I wonder if this is the big news. And I walk in the green room, and my manager's there, my wife is there, and my daughter is there, and my in-laws are there, and they've got big signs to say number one and a cake. And it was very sweet.
That is great, yeah.